Rise and shine on Australia's Vision Christian Radio.
A Tuesday podcast for you here on the Rise and Shine
very
podcast.
Very serious there.
Very, very serious Tuesday.
Yes, of course.
It is a, no, it's not a very serious day at all. Listen, the exciting news is we'll get straight into the show.
Okay.
We've got a text message number
coming. Yes.
Apparently it's already here. We're just
behind the scenes. There's some training required.
Yeah, and there's a different type of portal that we're supposed to be looking at to see because apparently if we look at it in a different thing, we can see the if people send us a photo via that.
Well, that's what we want to see. I want to see photos.
Yeah, yeah. Well, if you want to see photos, videos and all that other great stuff, we've also starting this week a Facebook page and a Facebook group. So you'll be able to get into the Facebook group. If you want early access to that, we're saying that you can email us.
That's right. Give us an email now on riseandandshine@vision.org.au. We've already had a couple come through to be our first contenders.
Yeah, yeah.
And you're going to put up some barriers of entry, I think, by asking some tough questions.
Very tough questions.
I think we should keep it as easy as possible. Like, we'll see.
Who are the hosts of Rise and Shine?
I think that could be a stumbling block.
Well, you know, if they can't, I'm going to make. Don't worry, I'll make the alternative questions very, very simple. I want to do multiple choice, so they don't have to get.
So you either
can pick out. Let's see. Let's work it out now. I want to do. You know, who are the hosts? Obviously, the correct answer, Fel and DJ.
Sure.
The other alternative things I'm thinking about doing: Graham Kennedy and Ugly Dave Gray. Do you know who those
as an option?
As an option.
Okay. Graham Kennedy. I'm like, what? Yes. Okay. Yes. Yes. I know Graham Kennedy.
Graham Kennedy, the wonderful, ugly Dave Gray. You know, for people in my era, that hopefully will bring a smile on their face. And then what's a third option? Something absolutely silly where people will go, well, these obviously aren't the hosts.
Like Donald Duck or something.
The Mickey Mouse, Donald Duck.
Sure.
There we go. There are your three options.
Well, and look, if I was answering it, I would answer that just because it, you know. It seems
we want to make it simple.
It's fun.
We want to make it simple. Okay. Maybe we should leave that blank and see all the different responses and how people spell Fel, Val, Bell. Yeah, you know, all the different.
Well, it's a tricky one. You know, it's hard. We thought we were doing them a favor by shortening Felicia.
I've heard. Maybe we will leave it blank because it might be interesting to see all the different alternatives of DJ we get as well. Because there's been CJ, BJ, AJ. Someone said the other day. We just answer to anything, so that's okay.
Hey there.
You too. That's another one you can choose. Keep an eye out for that. We'll let you know across everywhere. We'll let you know here on the podcast and, of course, on the show when finally we get the Facebook page, the Facebook group, and the new text message number that you can program in. Maybe you just don't want to do it via Siri.
Well, listen to some examples today. We might even get to some more tomorrow. I think we had time perhaps for some more. We ran out of time today.
Yeah.
If you've got a story where Siri's done you a disservice after you listen today, send us a message or jump on the phone call tomorrow morning.
Amen. Enjoy the show.
It's the best way to start your day. Rise and shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
And we're thanking God for some new members to the Vision family.
Yeah.
We always love seeing new stations coming on. And great to chat with Jean last week about all of the work that the guys have been doing out there on the road early this year. Another new station that's joined the family.
Yeah.
Canawindra
in New South Wales.
Yeah.
Station number 818.
Amazing.
And 818.
You can listen to us there on 88 FM. It's, for those who might not know, it's located between Orange and Cowra. So it's about that 300 Ks west of Sydney.
Yeah.
I always love a fact. And the fact about Canawindra that got my attention this morning is that it's the ballooning capital of Australia.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that exciting? So I don't think that means they blow up balloons. I think it means they might go up in the sky in balloons.
Yes.
Have you done that, DJ?
I have. I've gone up in a hot air balloon. Yeah, lots of fun. You've got to get up early in the morning to go. And I didn't do it in
Canawindra.
Yeah, I didn't do it there. Did it on the Gold Coast there, flying above all the.
It can be a bit chilly.
All the theme parks. I had a great time. So maybe we need to do the show from there.
Well, it's quite quiet up in the air, so it probably actually would be quite good for acoustics.
Yeah.
But there you go. We'll go to Canawindra for that. But there's a couple of others as well.
I've got a feeling this is where we come unstuck every time.
Oh.
I think it's pronounced Canawindra.
Do you?
Yes. I'm looking at it here. Even though it looks like that, I think it's pronounced Canoundra.
Well, maybe someone from Canoundra or Canoundra could give us a buzz.
Yes.
Introduce us to their town and say hello. We would love it.
Tell us the right way to
maybe
pronounce it.
Maybe you've been a grey nomad. It tells me that there's a lot of people who come through. It's very RV friendly. Maybe someone's travelling through and could give us a buzz.
Yeah, on the way out to parks or somewhere.
A welcome to the town. That'd be great.
I love it. I love it. That would be a lot of fun. Let us know and welcome to the Vision family. Number 818. This went online just last month. So welcome, brand new. And please, if you know anybody out in that area, let them know. They could be tuning in on 88 FM. If you've got a pronunciation for us, we'd love to hear it.
It's the best way to start your day.
Rise and shine.
Rise and shine.
With Fel and DJ on Vision.
And look, that's quite a timely song, isn't it? Because there's been a lot of talk about a particular big, moon and star.
Yes.
And not a collision, but an overlap that's got everyone in a tizzy, got everyone excited. A bit of a solar ellipse happened in some parts of the world overnight.
Exactly. Well, it just happened, I literally think a couple of hours ago, as we're starting our day today over here, we've heard so much. I don't know about you, but I've heard so much about this in the news. And so many, Christian reporters and, people into different, theories and stuff like that, talking about this massive total solar eclipse, that's happening across the USA. And I don't know if you've seen any of the stories, it's going this way and then it's an X from the last time and it's, crossing over and the middle of the two, eclipses from a couple of years ago. And this one, it's going over a town called Rapture in the USA and it's going over a town called Nineveh. And it's got this one and the whale and a giant. So many different people.
No, I haven't heard any of that. I was sleeping blissfully unaware that there was anything controversial. To me, it's just exciting to see
a solar eclipse.
Exactly. It's one of those things that's happened for a long time, will happen to the future.
Yeah.
And a great reminder of Psalm 19, where it talks about the heavens declaring the glory of God, the skies proclaiming the work of his hands.
I love it.
Incredible and how everything works together.
Yeah, and that's it. It's been a massive, very popular tourism thing, especially along Texas, where they were getting a total, the sun, the moon and the sun were totally, the moon was totally eclipsing the sun.
Mm.
In fact, they were, the local hotels, Airbnbs, even the local, taxis and Uber drivers and stuff were like tripling their prices.
Well, that's nice. isn't it helpful when the sky increases your tourism? I can see some great images though of people. Obviously, you're not supposed to watch it with your
naked
eyes uncovered.
Yeah, yeah.
So there's all sorts of contraptions being developed to try and help people see that safely, which is interesting to think how you would do it. And even onto your iPhones and things, little filters and stuff like that. So pretty cool.
It is very, very cool. And some great shots coming out of the total eclipse. Question I wanted to think about, maybe we can come back and have a think about this.
Yeah.
I often ponder, because there's so many different Christian teachers and, from different persuasions, from all over the map, who really jump on board, things like this and say, hey, this is a sign of Jesus coming back. I often wonder if that does... I often wonder what Jesus thinks of that, because is that something that you're thinking, man, is people going to, because there's been a lot of preachers, and television ones and stuff in the States who are like, on this day of the eclipse, this is going to happen. Well, it hasn't happened. Some of the things that they predicted hasn't happened. Do people look onto that and go, oh, that's more, I'm not interested in Christianity because they've seen that in the news? Or is Jesus sitting there going, I love the fact that you are looking forward to my return. I love the fact that you're so keen on this. I'm just, pondering the different questions there. So maybe we'll listen to Matt Maher. If you've got a thought about it, let us know. 1-800-316-316. Would love to hear your thoughts on it as well.
And look, we're coming up to the news, DJ, but you were just asking a question about the stars.
About the stars.
About
the eclipse and everything like that. And we've got the lovely Ruth on the line, Ruth from Geelong, our previous carryover champion.
She's a very good champion. Our champion of champions.
Ruth, when it comes to, looking ahead and people are talking about the signs and everything like this, and we've just had this big eclipse in America, where's your heart at with all of this?
I say, even so, come Lord Jesus.
Yeah. Oh, that's it. That's it. Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, that's what we really long for. Yeah.
Yeah. In the midst of whatever, no matter what the signs are, no matter what's happening, you know, the heart's cry is, for Jesus to return.
It's so true. And always remind
keep looking up.
Yes.
Keep looking up. Yeah.
Keep looking up. He'll come.
Live as if it's today.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I love that one. I love that one. Thank you, Ruth. Thank you, Ruth.
Rise and shine with Fel and DJ. Fel DJ. On Vision Christian Radio.
Look who's come into the studio. Good morning, Tony from the newsroom.
Good morning, Fel from the Fel and DJ show.
He's back from his holiday. He's refreshed. He's dancing around. We've got to ask, where did you end up on your holiday?
I went to Canberra because that's where my son and my grandchildren are. And these are a couple of twin boys, aged just under four,
awesome.
Who are very, very lively. So I'm suffering a few battle wounds with the children. You know, they love dinosaurs. They know every dinosaur in existence.
Mm.
And I got stabbed in the head with a dinosaur.
In Canberra, battling the dinosaurs. Here I am thinking he's down in Canberra getting, Yeah, exactly. The hot news from the parliaments. No, you're fighting dinosaurs down there. I love it. I love it.
It sounds much harder than politicians.
Well, great to have you back here and bringing us, some fresh news from the Vision News team. What's making news and what's keeping your interest up there?
Okay, well, we hear a lot about the Gaza war and the tragedy that is.
Mm.
But one of the results of that we haven't heard much about, which is going to shake up Israel quite a lot, is that the Supreme Court there has just ruled that the ultra-Orthodox young men must now serve in the military.
Whoa! Because they're exempt.
They are exempt, and they have been exempt for 76 years since the State of Israel was born.
Really?
But at that time, there were only about 400 religious students that spend their whole time studying the Torah, the first five books of the Bible. But now the government is going to take away a monthly stipend that they get. It's not a lot. It's only about $300 a month, but when you add that up, that's going to impact on these seminaries that they go to, which are called yeshiva, and some of them may have to close down. It's the biggest shock to the what they call the Haredim, Haredi people, in basically since the birth of Israel, and they're weighing up what to do about it.
Well, it's so unusual because at the moment the news that we're getting from a lot of places is that the Orthodox, religious guys have sort of taken over the government and Bibi's been listening to them, but obviously they haven't got as much sway over the parliament over there than what we think.
Well, they do have sway, but if they are not in the government, they will have no power.
Mm.
And if they're in the government, they will be influential. They've already made threats that they will leave the government. They hold about 11 seats in Netanyahu's coalition of 64 seats, but that's still just a slim majority. And all the polls have the current government is on the nose with a lot of people in Jerusalem.
Yes, yes.
And the rest of Israel. So it may be that the Haredi parties will not pull out of the government because they have more power within the government. If they do pull out, Netanyahu is stuck. He will have to call another election, which he's unlikely to win because some of his government really want the ultra-Orthodox young men to serve in the military, like every other Israeli.
How many are we talking about? Is it because you're saying it was quite a small number to begin with, 400. How many people are we talking about?
We're talking about up to around 60,000.
Oh, wow. So it's a big group.
That is in a longer-term lookout, but immediately it's 13,000.
Okay.
And it is already in force. The only problem is that the military is unlikely to rush them into service because of their religious beliefs that they cannot work together with women.
Wow.
Now, Haredi women will not be forced to serve at all.
Okay. Okay, so there's sort of like an exemption. It's still a partly exemption there. That is fascinating. Very, very different from where I thought Israel was going around with what we're hearing with, you know, the who's looking after the government there. But an interesting one to keep our eye on with everything that's happening over in Israel and Gaza, especially with the military. We've got Tony from the newsroom here with us, giving us some of the news that is making news waves for them upstairs.
And Tony from the newsroom.
We just played 1,000 times. We're not talking about someone who's 1,000 years old, but I saw a really interesting story on your desk about someone who's over 100 years old recently.
Yes. There is a man in Venezuela,
which
is at the top of South America, and he almost made it to 115.
Okay.
Wow.
He just a few, I think it was a couple of months short of 115. His name was Juan Vicente Perez Mora.
Oh, great name.
Yes, it is a very good name. He deserved to live long just for that. And he passed away. But when they asked him what his secrets to his longevity was, he said that he believed in God for every day, and he carried him in his heart every day.
Wow.
Awesome.
And he also said, I like to work hard, and I like to respect people, and I also drink a drop of aguardiente every day.
Right.
And that is a little bit alcoholic, so... I don't know how he did it, but he survived.
Maybe he preserved himself after 150 years. Dear. I love that one there.
Wow.
A little news story. We'll see if that makes the bigger news there. But I love the fact that he's giving a shout out to God in his 115 years. What else has been making news on around the rounds?
Okay. Well, we remember about a year ago there was signs of revival at American universities.
Yeah, Asbury
University in Kentucky, and it for 16 days they had non-stop prayer, worship, testimonies, sharing, and it went on and on. And
so
it only stopped because the university had to get back to its normal business. It wasn't going to be financially viable if they allowed the revival type scenes to go on and on. But since then, all last year, there were more similar outpourings of faith and a response to the gospel at universities across America.
Mm.
And it's still continuing.
Wow.
There's a group that formed out of that called Unite US, and they hold like about once a month, they will target a particular university and hold a big gospel event there. Mm. And they get thousands of students attending them. The last one was just a week ago in the University of Georgia. And they had 8,000 people turn up.
Wow.
And then spontaneously, they rushed to get baptized. And believe it or not, they got baptized in the back of pickup trucks.
Wow.
I think those that could withstand water in the tray.
Wow.
They got baptized in that. Others bought in some old baths and stuff and dipped them in there. And there were hundreds baptized there. And that repeats what's happened at University of Florida in February, University of Alabama in March. So it's going on and on. And this is just very encouraging. But it's mainly Southern universities they're targeting at the moment.
Mm.
But another group called the Christian Union, and this is run by young people themselves, is taking on the challenging task of preaching the gospel at the Ivy League schools.
Wow.
Which are much more radical. We're talking Harvard, Yale, Columbia, those sort of universities which have seen quite radical scenes following the Hamas invasion of southern Israel and a lot of anti-Semitism problems there. But these students still are getting a good response. It's still going on now and will go on for several weeks.
Mm.
And they're getting a good response from these sort of prestigious universities, which have been in a little bit of trouble over their reaction to what happened in Israel.
Yeah, I follow a couple of young artists, Christian artists, Christian musician artists, who are based in the northern universities, and they're out there, like, they're performing just in the quad every day, singing, doing praise and worship, and I think they're getting away with it. You know, again, with these types of universities, they're all very racially divided, and they're very, you know, big on different racial politics and stuff like that. A lot of the students who are in there preaching the gospel are from Asian countries, believers coming in from there. So it's almost like, oh, we want to say something. We don't appreciate it, but we're not going to say something because they're playing that. So it's a really interesting dynamic, and these young students are really switched on, and they're taking advantage of that sort of weird politics that is going on and going, hey, we don't care what you think. As long as we can tell you about Jesus, we're going to keep on doing this. So it's really interesting to see these young kids coming through doing that.
It is. It's a really encouraging phenomenon, and it's probably – We may be getting a distorted view of these universities. I was during my holidays, I met a professor from University of Ohio, and he said that the students are split 50-50.
Wow.
No, left wing, right wing. Wow. There's a lot of conservative students.
But the noisy left wing is what we see in the news quite often. Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. We get a bit of a distorted view of what most American students are actually like.
Mm, interesting stuff. I love that. Well, listen, make sure you head over to vision.org.au. Look for the news stories, those focus articles and things like that. If you see the name Tony Davenport, now you know a little bit about the man behind the name here.
Across Australia, this is Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
And DJ, you've got an announcement to make.
Oh, I think we should have some announcement music.
Oh, you got some?
Let's see. I have got...
okay, give me your best.
Exciting
announcement music. What have you got?
I've accidentally deleted a whole bunch. The one that I've got is this one.
Oh.
Is that...
Well, maybe if we were...
It gets a bit more exciting.
It doesn't?
Yeah, about here. All right, big announcement. Are you ready? The Rise and Shine Facebook page and Facebook group is coming sometime this week. Hopefully later on today. It's taken us a while to work it all out, but Facebook page, a brand new Facebook page dedicated to Rise and Shine. Now, the funny thing is, years ago, there was a Facebook page dedicated to Rise and Shine.
Did you dig it out,
Robert? No, it's long gone. All absorbed into the bigger vision one.
That would have been
funny to pull out the old stuff from Robbo and Becky. Yeah. It would have been great. So we're starting a new Rise and Shine Facebook page,
right?
So people can jump on that and you get all your information about your favorite breakfast show. But we're also going to have a private group that you have to apply to get in.
Oh,
you know, when you join a community
group.
Yeah, well, the
front
two...
Front loader versus top loader?
No, that was one of the suggestions of the question. I said no, because we can't, you know...
Discriminate.
We're not going to discriminate for that.
Everyone would get a yes. It would just be that you actually... whatever you put would be the correct answer. Yes. So what sort of questions are you thinking about?
Well, number one question, because we want to be able to contact everybody, we're going to ask for people's email address. Send us your email address so we know that you're a real person.
Okay,
so that's one thing. Yeah. But not everyone
has an email address.
Well, if they're on Facebook, they've got to have a Facebook.
Yeah, sure.
You know, put in something. And then the next question that we'll do is we'll probably have a multiple choice question of who are the two current hosts of Rise and Shine.
Oh, well, that could be tricky.
Well,
can they get it wrong and still get into the group?
Well, if they don't know, it's Fel and DJ. I think we're in trouble. I'm very tempted because of the name Fel, full name Felicia. You have had so many variations of your name.
That is true.
My favorite one is someone called up the other day and said, "Oh, it's so good to speak to you, DJ and Val."
I can understand. I can get that one. It's hard to get.
So maybe we have some multiple choices of how you pronounce Fel's name.
Oh, that is very hard. Well, I don't think that should discriminate against you.
No.
Unlike everyone come in.
Exactly.
Very fun.
We just want to keep the human. You know, we just want to have the humans,
a
keep
human
the bots
only.
Out. Yeah, exactly.
Are you a human?
So within the group is a chance to be able to share some more photos. This is what's going on, some videos.
The inner sanctum.
People can send photos of where they're listing, and we can get to
know
each other.
That's a bit fun, isn't it?
Yeah. Get to know everybody a little bit more in the new Rise and Shine Facebook group, which is coming, hopefully, maybe by the end of the day. We'll see. Maybe tomorrow. But
maybe the next day.
Maybe the next.
But this week.
Watch this space.
Let's say this week.
That's all I'm saying. Watch this space.
Oh, dear.
If you want to be the first one in, if you want to really be like early access in, maybe send us an email.
Okay.
And we'll make sure we invite you as soon as it's happening. riseandshine@vision.org.au. riseandshine@vision.org.au. And we'll let you in first before everybody else.
Just the right mix of things to inspire and things to make you smile. Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
Fel, I'm excited as usual. Every couple of weeks here on a Tuesday, we have the wonderful Brett and Kate Ryan, Focus on the Family Australia. In amongst their busy schedule, they make time for us. And we haven't talked about this in a while, guys. Grandparent duties is one of the most important things on your busy schedule now. How's all that going?
Unfortunately, three of them are now overseas in Romania. So we're doing grandparenting by distance at the moment, and I'd imagine many of your listeners would be doing the same thing. And how do you connect with your children or grandchildren from long distance? But it doesn't mean that you're any less important. It's just that you can't have the physical contact. But modern technology is a wonderful thing, and you can have an impact even across the miles.
I love that, because we've got that in our family. We've got grandparents who are across the country from my kids, and it's expensive to go visit on a regular basis. So lots of it's done from a distance. So from both the perspective of, and I'll pitch it both and you can choose either, the perspective of me as a mum connecting in with grandparents over the other side, and also for grandparents, how can they make an impact and connect back with their grandkids when there is distance in between?
Well, I'm going to do it from say yours and my perspective with our parents. Yes. So setting an example for our children.
Right.
The grandparents are so important. They hold the history in their hands. Especially if they've got a faith, they're leaving a legacy. So the Bible's very clear about honouring parents. And so if we don't treat our parents, their grandparents, with respect, they are not either. They are not going to see them of value. But if we demonstrate how important they are, they are going to jump on board. There's so much to learn.
Yeah. Talking about tools and – oh, no, I've totally lost it there with the question. I'll go for a different one. Kate, you brought up something there that has triggered something that might be a little bit too personal here for this time of the morning, but I'm going to go there anyway.
Oh, go there then.
Yeah, you
can. Okay, go.
As soon as I say that, Phil's like, let's go.
That's the point right there.
My oldest son, shout out to Drummond, is very serious with his girlfriend. Another shout out to the beautiful Monica. And I would say that he is, in a lot of good things, trying to pattern the examples that he's seen of parents that have gone before him. Now, I would say that I love my mother-in-law and she loves me. Sometimes it's a strained relationship. Sometimes it can be a little bit, there's a little bit of overbearing, mother-in-law type of thing, because it comes out of her love for my children, her grandchildren, and her daughter, who's my wife. I'm beginning to see that same pattern begin with my son.
Right.
And I'm wondering, I'm sitting there as you do, you always blame yourself as a father. You go, have I given him the wrong example here? Is he treating his future mother-in-law maybe in some of the bad things that he's picked up from me?
Oh, well, that is, you're right.
It's deep.
I'm off. There, see you later.
They've called it. It's your fault, DJ.
I really don't want to sit here and do that. but we
we laugh, but it's true.
We do have to make a choice in our relationships and say, is what's happening there, do I have to stand my ground on something, in terms of a relationship with an in-law, or do I just choose to love?
Grace.
Yes, and it's not. They have this relationship with their, if it's a daughter, so obviously your wife, and they haven't got the same relationship with you. But you've got to try and see them that they're your mother too. When you got married, they are now your new parents. And you're their new son. And so that is the aim, to love them as if they were your parents. And so
find ways to honor them.
Yes, finding ways to honor them.
Because they created your wife So they must have done something right.
Yes. And so for us, even, you know, I'm very close to my mum, but I've always said to Brett's mum, I want you to drop in any time. Oh, it's not the same as you and your mum. I said, I don't care. You are my mum too. Feel free to drop in any time. I love you.
Oh, that's wow. Beautiful. And that's look, beautiful. It brings...
So, yeah. It's really important that they know that there's two sides, because often a girl will go draw the man into the mother's side, and the guy's side of the family kind of gets forgotten. So it's really important that there are two families that love the two of you and want to see you succeed.
Wow. That is beautiful. And look, it comes back to that Ephesians 6, 1 to 3, where it says, honouring your father and mother, the first commandment with promise. But look, I think what we might do is just let that settle for a second. There was a lot to take in. DJ needs a minute.
I need to lay down over here.
And DJ. We'll go to a song, give him a minute, and we'll come back and have a bit more of a chat.
Fel, I've recovered. I've had a little bit of a breather. Fel had to come over with the smelling salts and get me back up off the floor there. But back up here, we're getting deep and personal. I've took it on a bit of a tangent because we started talking about grandparents.
It's now DJ's therapy session.
And we've gone to around that, you know, because as you build a family, you've got grandparents, you've got in-law. Part of that is the in-laws. And, sometimes I've been blessed with great in-laws, and a lot of people saying that, but some I know families where it's really toxic
or difficult
in the relationship with the in-laws there. How do you work with that?
Well, there's a number of different things, and we, you know, obviously giving you the abridged version, but there's a lot more on how to communicate effectively and how to handle conflict healthily. And it's important to have these brave and much needed conversations to honour them as adults, and you're an adult, and to try and find where you agree with, and there are some things that you may not necessarily agree with, but you're going to still show honour and respect to one another in a way that you want to have set them up for success with having a relationship with your children, their grandchildren, and the same thing with you having a relationship with them as well. You want to be able to have these conversations, and it might be that you need to have a face-to-face, ideally, and talk these things through.
And it's very different when you say toxic. There's toxic, which you generally steer clear of. But then there's just complicated. You know, there's complicated relationships. And there are ways to work through that in an honouring way. I mean, we speak to a lot of people culturally, you know, where it might be a patriarchal or matriarchal culture, and how do you respectfully say that you are the parents of the children and still honouring them? And it has to start with, we love you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because it sets a grounding and a base.
And we want to have a relationship
We want to have a relationship. We love you. But these are the few issues that could we work through.
Yeah.
And one is respect, you know, respecting that you're the parents. Sometimes grandparents can go off on a tangent and they want to spoil the children, but you don't want them to do that. So you need to talk through that. I wouldn't do anything without asking my kids when I'm looking after their children. If I go, that might be a thing for them, I will ring them and say, is it okay if I?
Yeah, right.
Because I want to respect them, and they really appreciate that.
I love
because
that.
It's important.
I love that you're thinking about the impact that those relationships are having on your kids. And so the way that that conflict is resolved, or the way that discussion is held, and even how you talk within your family about your grandparents, is going to filter down to the kids.
Don't bag the grandparents in any way, shape or form in front of your children. Mm-hmm. If you want to talk about things that are upsetting you about them, do it away from the children. Mm-hmm.
Great advice. I'm making notes here as we speak. Obviously, great resources as usual over at families.org.au, searching around these topics. And Brett, you often say if people can't find that right article, that they should get in touch.
Yeah, very much so. Well, this one will be easy because they just have to go to resource at families.org.au, go to resources and download the Grandparent Toolkit. Very simple.
Too easy, Brett. Thank you so much. We'll see you next time.
You're welcome. Okay, bye-bye. Bye.
Rise and shine.
Rise and shine.
With Fel and DJ on Vision Christian Radio.
DJ, we've been talking about some new technology that, well, not new, but new to us, that our Rise and Shine listeners, a family, we're going to be able to connect a little bit tighter in, a bit of a closer hug.
Exactly.
Facebook, our own page coming soon.
A Facebook page coming soon, and not just a Facebook page, a Facebook group, so we can share some photos. We can, you know, if you take a beautiful picture of you on the way to work of a sunrise, you can pop that up there.
Coffee cup, what you're having for breakfast,
wherever you're listening.
Ruth could send us some awesome images for her brekkie.
Exactly. You send some recipes. So we're going to have a nice, you know, group happening there. This is all happening in the next couple of days. Keep your eyes peeled. Brand new Rise and Shine Facebook page and Facebook group to get to know each other. But the technology doesn't stop there.
But wait. There's more. What else is coming that would be high tech that would help us connect even better in this day of information age?
Mate, we are cutting edge technology here on The Breakfast Show. Don't say that we're not leading the way.
We're 20 years behind.
In the next couple of days, be ready.
Yes.
Text messaging The Breakfast Show is happening.
So you could, in the next couple of days, when it's announced,
we
would have a number that you could text during the show.
Yeah, we're going to have it. So if you want to text us during the show, we're going to have a mobile number there that you can text us. You can send us, you know, we're going to ask opinions. You can fly a text
hashtag
in there.
Hashtag cool.
Yes, you can all do all that stuff. We'll be able to see your text messages as they come flying in from all over Australia. So we're very excited to launch that. But a lot of times, though, this is where you've got to be careful.
You've got to be careful on text.
Text messaging, you know, it doesn't really carry, you know, sometimes it either doesn't carry the emotion that you want it to carry or in the day and age, I don't know about anybody else, it seems like my iPhone is going backwards with how awful the autocorrect is. And knowing what, like, I don't know if my thumbs are getting lazier or clumsier, but the, you know, the words are all over the place. Spelling is horrible. I don't know what's going on.
And sometimes it puts words in that you didn't even mean to be there.
No.
But also there can be errors even in just, like, sometimes people shorten words.
Yes.
LOL. What does that mean? I've got some interesting stories I know about.
Really?
Where things have gone horribly wrong. But I wonder if there's anyone out there who've made a texting mistake, a faux pas, if you will, with the text. Either you've autocorrect has made that mistake for you. You can blame technology.
That's what I do every time.
Or perhaps if you've just used an acronym wrong, we'd love to hear about it this morning as we prepare to launch our text on 1-800-316-316. For now, you'll have to call.
Yes.
In a couple of days, you could text your answer, which would
be fun as well. The cutting edge technology here on Rise and Shine.
And we're talking all things text related because this is new technology for us on the show. You're going to be able to soon when we've got it all up and running, we're on the way to having our own text number.
Exactly.
So you can text us with your thoughts. You can call or text. How cool will that be?
It'll be very, very good.
It's good when it works, but when it's not, it can feel a little bit...
And again, well, listen, don't panic. The number is going to stay the same. The 1-800 number that everyone's got, you can still call in that. But the text message number line will be just for you to be able to text, drop us some information. But with all this technology, sometimes, you know, it doesn't actually go to plan.
It can go horribly wrong.
You've had an example of where it's
gone. Well, I do. Like a pastor friend of mine was telling me a story. She was saying that she, you know, you're getting text messages from your parishioners saying, you know, good news, sometimes bad news, though.
Yeah.
She got a message through from someone saying they had a loved one that had passed away.
Yes.
And her pastor's heart was breaking for them.
Oh.
And she wanted to text them back straight away. You know, she'd call later, obviously.
Yeah.
So she texted back and said, my heart is with you, LOL. Because she thought LOL meant lots of love. It doesn't, though, does it?
No.
What does LOL mean?
Laugh out loud.
Yeah.
Laugh
so she said the laugh out loud to this poor parishioner who was in need of a bit of love.
And you can't really blame that one on the technology, though.
No, that one we can't blame tech.
You can't blame that
one. Although, you know, it's run away with us, hasn't it, when you have to put acronyms in rather than words. But have you had an example, DJ, where perhaps autocorrect has gone wrong?
Look, my wife loves to send messages via Siri on the phone.
Okay,
and she's driving along, she's been a good girl, you know, speaking
Siri,
to the... Hey, you know, and
tell
apologies,
DJ this.
Apologies if everybody's phone is now going off with Hey Siri. But, you know, sending messages like that. Well, a little while ago, we were giving away, you know, Ficking in Country tickets and talking about Ficking in Country. And the lovely listener, Maria in Adelaide, was messaging me via Instagram there. And she, again, being a good girl, doing it all via Siri.
Okay.
And she was asking Siri to talk to me about Ficking in Country.
Yes.
Well, it didn't really hear for King and Country very well, and it actually started putting in some swear words instead.
Oh, no.
And I won't go into it. So I'm getting these messages from Maria, faithful, godly woman, who is not checking the messages as they're sending out to me.
No, about she's driving, so she can't read the message.
About For King and Country. Oh, Maria. And I just went with it. I was like, oh, so you're not happy about For King and Country? And she was like, she was like, I'm so embarrassed. I said, it's okay. I can see that you sent it by Siri. Oh. It's all good. Siri, I didn't know I had such a potty mouth on her and was sending you the naughty messages there. So I was laughing at least.
I think you would have been laughing hysterically.
Poor Maria wasn't, though. Maria wasn't.
I'm sure she was laughing in the end. Talking about text messaging and Siri and auto text and when things go astray.
Yeah.
And I've got Shane on the line from Portland in Victoria. Good morning, Shane.
Hello.
Now, have you got an example for us of any pieces of technology perhaps doing you a misjustice?
Yeah, so I'm a pastor and I was at a pastor's meeting and it was back when Siri was new. And I was demonstrating to a group of pastors how Siri works. Uh-huh. And I said, hey, Siri, text my wife, I love you.
Oh,
and Siri spoke back, which wife? And so that was the end of the conversation because everyone was laughing. So.
Your secret, Siri had uncovered your secret life. the other wife that you
had. How many wives are there?
Oh, boy.
That's right. Yeah, that's right.
Oh, no. Oh, that's it.
I tell you, Siri is, she needs to be fired, I think. I think she needs to go back and do some retraining. Oh, Shane, that's a classic example. Thanks so much for the call, buddy.
No worries.
Have a good one. Say hello to the wives. Say hello to the wives as well for us. Oh, dear. Look, we love hearing your stories about AuToKoRRekT or Siri doing you bad. It seems like Siri is being thrown under the bus. It's not so much AuToKoRRekT. It's all coming down
true.
To Siri.
Well, you and yes, perhaps we just need to make sure we're very clear in our messaging.
Exactly, exactly.
Across Australia, this is Rise and Shine with Fel and DJ on Vision.
And we've come to the end of the show, so it's the time of the day when you get to call the song that's going to take us into the day, the curtain call.
Love it.
Well, I've got Carol on the line. Carol, what can we play for you?
That lovely, If the Lord Builds a House.
Oh, yes.
Is it CC Winer?
Yeah. Yep.
I think it is. I think it is. If the Lord builds a house.
I feel like we could sing it, Carol, otherwise.
Oh, you know, it's Hope Dast. Are you thinking of the Hope Dast version? Yeah. That's Hope Dast. She's great. If the Lord builds the house. Yeah, beautiful song.
That is so lovely.
That's a good one to take us into the day, too.
I like it. All right. Well, Carol, going out to you today. Here it is. If the Lord builds the house, Hope Dast.
Thank you. I've built up my own day, but the wall. Trusted my own strength, but it was seeking house. Nobody can tear it down.
Hope Dast. If the Lord builds the house, going out to lovely Carol. I love it when Carol calls.
I now understand. Listening to this song again, I'm like, I can understand why you'd get confused with CC Winans. Yes, definitely got the vibe
sort of
there.
A sound.
Love it. Great song to finish off there. Thank you, Carol, for that lovely curtain call. If you've got a curtain call, you can give us a call anytime, 1-800-316, or drop us a line over at riseandshine@vision.org.au. And very soon, text it in with our text message number.
Or on the Facebook group. Ooh. I mean, the sky is the limit,
I know.
Really.
Look out. We're going to be all over the place soon. We're finally getting there.
Next we'll get my son to do a Discord server for us and we'll be right up to date.
Well, I would be in that, but I think a lot of people are like, hang on, what is a Discord server?
Well, I had to get him to explain it to me three times, but there you go.
Yeah, lots of different things. We're going to keep it simple. Facebook page, Facebook group, text message. I think that's the best way to go. But don't worry, the phone number's not going anywhere. You can still give us a call or shoot us an email anytime. Well, listen, make sure you download today's podcast, subscribe to our podcast in all of your podcast, readers, wherever you get your podcast from. Or if you're used to, getting your information there from the Vision app, you can find it all in the Vision app as well. Just search for Rise and Shine. We will see you bright and early back here tomorrow. Have yourself a wonderful Tuesday.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Thanks for taking time to listen to this audio on demand from Vision Christian Media. To find out more about us, go to vision.org.au.